I'm in it.
You better get moving. I won't be late to my own wedding.
Okay, come on down. Surprise! It's your wedding present.
Whoa! A queen-size bed!
Not just any queen-size bed. Got a quarter? I bought it from the Hackensack Motel 6. Don't worry, it's been disinfected. Whew, that really brings me back. You and Linda should have some wedding night on this thing. Oh, and then, maybe you can finish writing that song for my anniversary party. I wrote down some words. Maybe you could put them to music. After you get back from your honeymoon, of course.
Sure thing, Grandma. You know, I hope that 50 years from now, Linda and I are as happy as you and Grandpa are.
Of course you will be, dear. You were born romantic, just like your father was. I know your parents will be looking down on you today as you start your new life. Tell me, Robbie, are you nervous?
I mean, a little, but I'll be fine. I'm around weddings all the time.
Not about the wedding. About the wedding night. Will this be your first time with the sexual intercourse?
Hey!
Let's not talk about this.
Well, now, there's nothing to be ashamed of. You know, before your grandfather and I were married, I'd already been with 8 men.
You know, that's not really the kind of thing I want to know about.
That was a lot back then. That would be the same as like 200 men today.
Still don't want to know.
Well, actually,
let's not be late.
There was Arnie, Stephen, Daniel, Pedro.
This talk can wait.
Adam.
Or just not happen.
Ben. And once at summer camp, Joey and Radowski.
Now at last the dream is coming true. Cause all you need is me, and all I need is you. All I need is you. Where the hell are you?
Robbie? Do you think maybe we should call Linda?
No, I'm sure she's fine. Just a problem with her dress, or her hair, or something.
Hey, Robbie. Linda's mom just stopped by.
Oh, that was nice of her.
Yeah, she wanted me to give you this.
A note. Excellent.
To my dearest Rob, I think we need some space. Please forgive my timing. Dot, 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 smiley face. You see, I woke this morning prepared to walk on air, but realized that you cramped my style as I cramped my hair. You're just not that same person, the guy I used to know. I'm not in love with Robbie now, but Robbie 7 years ago. Hope this note is something that you can rise above. Deep down you weren't in love with me, you were just in love with. And so it's best we end this before we even stand. the I is dotted. Well, all broken.
Testing, testing, one, two, potato, potato. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry to inform you that there's been a bit of a snafu.
Oh God!
No, I mean, it's fine, everything is fine. It's just that there has been a slight change with the bitch ain't coming.
Oh, I know it, I hate her!
No, I'm sure that we all hate Linda. Right now, we need to be there for Robbie. Robbie! Where did Robbie go?
So it's your wedding thing. I can guarantee that Bob will find me. Because love is what
so the girls are thinking of taking up a collection for Robbie, like a fruit basket, something nice, kiwis.
You know, you can write a song for Linda, and now she's never gonna hear it.
And after Glenn pops the question tonight, you're gonna have to start thinking about wedding music.
It's not just the gun.
Julia, honey, are you in there?
Is my mom still here?
Oh, you disappeared on me!
Mom, thank you for bringing my dress to work on such short notice, but I could really use some space right now.
Oh, she's having one of her freakouts.
Julia, sweetheart, there's only two reasons a man brings a woman to a place like Il Carousel. It's either to propose or to break up with her in a public place where she can't make a scene.
You think Glenn is gonna dump me?
Nice, Aunt Ange.
Oh, no, of course not. But on the off chance Glenn doesn't pop the question, you just gotta give him a little nudge. Try a little smile, a little wink, a little fake pregnancy.
I don't think that'll work with Glenn, who's a lot smarter than Dad.
Life. You and Glenn are fine, right, Aunt Angie?
Oh, there's not a doubt in my mind.
Tonight is the night. I mean, trust us.
Every 5 seconds a girl gets engaged, according to Cosmo's latest quiz. So every 5 seconds you get one more chance to make him get down on that knee. So he's gonna pop the question, and he's gonna pop the question. So there's no reason to stop, and question is love. Oh, pop the question.
I want Abby look like Cinderella.
And I'm like her fairy godmother, only slutty.
Gonna pop.
thinking to myself, I can't sell this crap for 12 and a half. All of a sudden, the phone rings, it's Booski. Now you know Ivan's buying, something's up. So we go upstairs and buy the 5 mil for ourselves.
But isn't that like trading or something?
They don't enforce that shit.
Crystal?
Yes, Luki?
Will you marry me, baby?
Oh, yes! Yes, Luki, yes! What took you so long?
What was that all about?
It's me! The reason why you think this place is now so crystal clear, like our relationship, we're going round in circles here, and where he's sitting, it's as if it all revolves around him!
Hey,
Tiffany!
What do you say we, make it official?
Oh my god! Donnie Jr.'s not gonna be a bastard anymore!
Everyone's having champagne. No, Lonnie, do you?
One more couple gets engaged, or I hear one more court. It's Hari Kari with the fancy little salad man. He makes the bubbly, which can only mean the outlook is grim.
It's kinda crazy here tonight.
He's telling me, if I hear one more proposal, well, maybe just one more? Oh my god, dude, I thought you'd never ask!
I know why we're here.
You do?
This is the end, right?
The end of what?
You know, the end of you and me as boyfriend and girlfriend.
Well, actually, yeah, it is. Because I want us to be a husband and a wife.
Oh my god!